Hello, this is Torsten Steinbach, architect at IBM for data and analytics in the cloud, and I'm going to talk to you today about the SQL Sandwich. This is actually about databases and object storage. So, and as you can see in the image, we are putting it together as a nice and tasty sandwich. So at the center of this sandwich, we have our data warehouse. So this is a very well established mechanism of storing and analyzing data, big data. But we're surrounding it now with more recent technology that is especially popular in the cloud, and this is object storage. And we have it as the buns basically for the sandwich at the top and at the bottom. Now, what's the purpose of having all of these components? What we have actually at the top is our initial place where we are landing and storing our raw data. So this might be things like log messages from applications, IoT messages from devices that are just coming in, and in a pretty raw format, we're able to just store them at the object storage for very low money, little money, and in a highly elastic manner. And in the data warehouse, however, we want to have our high quality data. Because the data warehouse is a much more sophisticated, but also much more expensive component to operate, to host, and to purchase. And at the bottom again, the object storage. Why do we have another object storage at the bottom? Well, this is where we have our archive data. Now, all of these components basically make sense in an end-to-end big data analytics use case, because we have new data arriving and being stored in the object storage. And here in the object storage, basically we are going to explore the data. So we try to find out what's actually in the data. And we prep the data, we prepare the data, cleanse it, make it higher quality, more curated. And we also conduct, to some extent, batch analytics directly at the data that is stored in the object storage. In a data warehouse, however, basically, we are able to do interactive analytics that requires certain SLAs for latencies, for performance response times, and so on. And why are we having this archive data again? Well, this is basically because you do not want to keep all of this data for years around in a data warehouse, because, as I told you, this is the more expensive thing to run of all of these components. So it makes sense of the data, for those data that is not hot anymore, that is not required for your daily business, to archive it off again against into an object storage. So that, for instance, you can still run things like compliance reports that you're required to do to be compliant with certain regulations. So these are the different types of analytics and things that you want to do with the data at the different stages of its life cycle, basically. Now, of course, a real sandwich shouldn't be as dry, so you want to have some sauce in there. So what is this sauce basically that glues these things together? It is basically an ETL mechanism. It allows you basically to read data from here and transform it so that it can be inserted here, and same from here to here. So basically data is traveling this way. Now, finally, you see, a sandwich is often something that, or is typically something that you do not eat in pieces, right? You do not just eat the patty or just the bun. You eat it as a whole thing. So you consume it as a whole thing. And that's also the same analogy that holds here, that while it makes sense to prepare a system that can serve these different types of workloads in the most efficient way and cost-effective way possible, it's of course hard if you always have to think about, do I go here, here, or here with this query? It should be more automatically figured out by the system. And for that reason, we are putting this all into a nice box. We're putting it all together, and we are using federation as a mechanism on top of all of that, that basically virtualizes the actual location of the data depending on its age or state of the pipeline that it is in. Now, finally, it's called a SQL sandwich. Why it's called a SQL sandwich? Well, because SQL is the essential thing for all of these things that you can see here. SQL is used for basically doing these analytics. These are SQL queries that we are running here. SQL is also used to do the ETL. And finally, SQL is also used in order to federate those things together. That's a SQL federation. Okay, voila. That's our SQL sandwich. And I hope this helps you to put in perspective the roles of object storage and data warehouses and how these two things can be put together into this nice and tasty format so that you can get the most out of the technology in combination. Thank you very much.